Hi, everybody, and welcome to Moodle Support Theater. We're looking at the Gradebook and Moodle 2.5 here at Humboldt State University, and I want to first remind you that these videos are not intended to take the place of a workshop or a one-on-one session, and that Moodle is not mandatory. You have your choice of grading methods. However, a lot of the changes in this version were made at the request of faculty. So here we are, video-based 2. I've added one sample assignment near the top, so we have something to play with, and we're going to go to our left-hand column, find the administration block, and about halfway down, there it is, grades. Let's give it a click. We're in the default view of the gradebook. This is the grader report view. It has student names, student emails, and the first change we made is that huge HSU ID that used to populate one of the columns, that's gone, and it's going to make it a lot easier if you're one of those individuals who likes to import and export your data to an Excel spreadsheet. Now, let's come to the upper right-hand corner where it says Turn Editing On. When we do that, sample assignment is listed, and there's a solid box and a dotted box after each person. The solid box is for numbers. The dotted box is where you can type in up to 150 characters of feedback. Don't try and put the entire paper in here. Don't try and do a lot of communication. You've got email, you've got messages, you've got Faculty Center. There's a lot of better ways to contact your students. This is for 100 to 150 characters. Now at the bottom of the page, in sort of a faded out fashion, is the update button. That was another faculty request we were able to put into motion. If you have a large class, let's say you've got 120 students and you're entering grades, it was not uncommon for a person to go from one page to the next without updating at the bottom. Then they lose their data, and that's not good. So for a couple of semesters now, we have had it as you enter the value in the solid box and then go to the next box, that just automatically locks the data in place. So you don't have to spend extra time trying to figure things out. I'm going to come up and turn my editing off. And a lot of people will say, where is the view that the student we'll see. So we are in View tab, Grader Report. We're going to come over to the User Report. Let's select that, and when we do, we're going to see in the upper right hand corner the option to choose either all of the users or an individual student. I'm going to choose our good friend Test Student 7. Now when Test Student 7 logs in, this is what they're going to see. Their data and their data only. They won't see any of the other persons in class. If you were to choose all users, and let's select that now, going back to the upper right hand corner, you can evaluate and review each student by scrolling up and down. I'm going to return to the grader report. We have tabs across the top. Categories and items we're going to visit and spend an awful lot of time on. So let's jump over that. Scales we're going to jump over. Letters are the grades set up in the class. I'm going to click that. This is based on how we grade here at HSU. 100 to 93% is an A, 92.9, etc. This can be changed and edited and is available for you to do so. Import and export is an entire lesson if you choose to use an Excel spreadsheet. Settings, let's select settings. Settings are some of the choices you can make on how things look. For example, the very first one, aggregate position. Do you want the course total on the far left or in the first position on the far right? Grade display type, use the drop down. There's a number of ways you can display a grade. A letter, a number, a percentage, and a letter. This is entirely up to you. Most of the defaults are set. The only one is here in the user report area where it says show feedback. Some people like to have a feedback column, some people don't, and that is your choice. Some people don't want the percentages to show. That's our second item from the top here in user report. Any changes you make, choose save. They will affect this class and this class only. It does not go to all of your classes. I'm now going to select my preferences, and there are again more choices. One of the more important things in the preferences tab here at the bottom in the general area is students per page. Now, it used to be the default was 10, and we doubled it to 20, and at faculty request, we've doubled that again to 40. Now, the one thing you do need to know is if you have a very, very big class, 120, 150 students, and you have a large number of assignments, if you choose too high a number of rows to display, this number is going to start reducing. This is to save your data. This is not something we've done. This is something Moodle has done internationally to prevent data loss for faculty. So during your training, please come in and we'll give you more information on that. And as always, save changes. Okay, that's just kind of a quick overview. I'm going to select categories and items, and I'm going to leave us there. Come back in our next installment. We'll show you the basics of setting up categories and items, and then we'll go through each of the different grading methods. So we look forward to seeing you again. Between now and then, we're in Library 315 at extension 3633.